Has your doctor recommended Biocidin? Are you worried that Biocidin is going to kill the good bacteria as well as potential gut infections? Do you use Biocidin? Let's get into it. It is after drop time. Biocidin is a supplement that has been around for over 30 years. So let's understand it. Biocidin is an antimicrobial. It is a biofilm disruptor, but please know that all biofilms are not bad. Sometimes when Biocidin is used and there's a negative reaction, which you might have heard about, negative reactions like anxiety or irritability, sometimes it's actually a detox reaction from the breakdown of the biofilm and release of things like heavy metals, oxalates, toxins, things like that. Let's get into clinical trials of humans using Biocidin. They have lots of different formulas. Let's talk about Biocidin liquid. That one has been shown in clinical trials that it has an immune modulatory effect, and they can see a 66% increase in IgA. The liquid formulation can be used in newborns all the way up to the elderly. And the reason why is because it can be titrated so easily for increasing the dosage. So you start with drops. All right, let's get into the capsule, which is very equivalent. And they're red looking. And one capsule equals 5 drops. This is the liposomal formulation. And a lot of doctors have been recommending this more and more as the preferred formulation. It's important to really understand how these different formulations impact your child, potentially. So the liposomal targets the bloodstream and the lymphatic system. It might actually be able to target intracellular as well. This is the most potent formula in the sense that it's going to penetrate into the body further than any of the other formulations. Keep in mind that if you're using the liposomal or if you've been recommended to use it, it is quite potent. So it's definitely something to use under knowledgeable guidance. Out of all their products, this one can cause the most intense die-off. And many times this can happen even after using the liquid or the capsule. And again, it's because the formulation penetrates much more differently. Now you might be thinking, is this going to kill the good bacteria in the gut? The company has done before and after gut microbiota testing. They don't see any decrease in beneficial bacteria from using Biocidin. They have seen an increase in acromantia, which is a strain of bacteria that strengthens the gut lining and helps prevent inflammation due to leaky gut. What is Biocidin used for? It has a long list, and that might be why your doctor is talking to you about using it. All right, let's go over. It can cover candida, clostridia, mold, borrelia, giardia, SIBO, neuroinflammation. However, for neuroinflammation, you usually have to use it much longer, like 6 months and more. Whereas for gut infections, many times it's used for a few months. Okay, how is it used? In my experience of seeing how the top 70 to 100 functional medicine doctors focusing on autism in the US use it, it's not their most powerful option. Okay, so it really depends on the level of infection. There's a variety of different ways to test for gut infections, right? And it depends on that list which one it is. You really want to do a lab test before using this. So you get the lab test back, and if it's a very strong active infection, normally Biocidin is not going to be used. A lot of times a prescription will be used. Again, it depends on the actual intensity of the infection. Okay, how is it used? In my experience of seeing how the top 70 to 100 functional medicine doctors focusing on autism around the world use this is that it's not their most powerful option. If there's a large candida infection, prescription will be used first. And then this is typically used as one of their first stopgaps after stopping the prescription. I have seen it used as a first-line therapy when the health concern is more in the milder range. So let me give an example for candida. The organic acid test, arabinose, let's say the arabinose level is between 60 and 90, maybe 100, 110, something along those lines. Typically, a prescription is not going to be used when it's in that range. That's an active infection, but it's not a real intense one. So if their rhabdomyosis is in that range, then something like Biocidin would be used. Typically, the liquid or the capsule would be used first, and then you might switch over to the liposomal. Most parents don't open the capsule because it doesn't really taste too good. And it's red, it's sometimes hard to mask. There is that liquid formulation, so you could certainly use that if your child isn't swallowing pills. The liposomal is in a pump form, and you want to take it on an empty stomach if possible. I know it gets really hard to schedule these different kind of supplements when they have to be on an empty stomach, but you want this to be on an empty stomach as much as possible. You squirt it under the tongue, child holds it for about 30 seconds, and that way the Biocidin can actually get into your bloodstream. I will give it a try. I have not tried this one yet. Let's see. I'm a little nervous as to what it's gonna taste like. Okay. Oh, there is a safety lock. There's a child lock on it. Okay, the child lock is off now. It tastes a little like pine needles. I don't know why. It's not like overly gross, but I can't say it's like fabulous. It's amazing how it does. I mean, this formulation, this liposomal formulation, woo, it's definitely being absorbed, and there really wasn't much to swallow. So I don't think your child would need to even hold it for 30 seconds. It goes, woo, it certainly does its job and gets into the bloodstream. You're not really concerned too much about having to swallow it. It's actually pretty cool the way it does that. The taste is not terrible, but I wouldn't say it's fabulous. Biocidin depends on the formulation, but Biocidin is definitely an opt. I have seen it done fantastic things in a variety of different infections and health concerns. It's certainly potent. You do want to be mindful of detox reactions, and Biocidin is definitely an opt.